Okay, so today, a little bit different type of project here. I'm going to design a car part from start to finish, and I'm gonna walk you through it so you can see exactly, this is a small part, right? So, but just kind of the basic steps involved. So in this case, I've already disassembled this, but this is a 2JZ-GE throttle body off like an 01 to 05 IS300, 98 to 05 GS300, that sort of thing. Again, I've already disassembled it. We've got the app sensor here, throttle blade control here, right? So like so. On this side, got another video about the drive-by-wire throttle control motor replacement, or delete, really. But not for today. Today we're working on designing a well, in this case, it's going to be a throttle lock, right? So the throttle lock is going to be designed to take the factory wire cable and make it a one-to-one ratio with the throttle plate inside. So where these normally are, they have all this play before the throttle motor starts to open. So we want to make it so it opens one-to-one with this, thus negating the need for the drive-by-wire part. Helpful on some standalones, manual transmission cars, that sort of thing. So anyways, design process. So what we've got to do is this guy, this little lever here, contacts this. And as you can see, as you rotate this, that's the full range of throttle pedal motion. Not very much, you know, maybe 60 degrees or something like that. Anyways, I've already made a little line on here, and that line correlates, so the bottom of this little center axle, we'll call it there, with the center of this axle. And if you see, the bottom of this is flat, as we'll call it like 90 degrees, or it's you know, horizontal with the bottom of that axle. So I drew a line on here that's flat or horizontal with the bottom of this axle. Of course, this sits like so. So this guy, that line, correlates with that. So now we know we need a piece that's gonna fill up the difference between this blue line and this lever to that point. But we also need to stay in place. So basically something that's round in the center is going to fill that void, right? There is a little space between here and here. We just need to find out how much we can use, and then attach a piece here on the outside that's going to fill the gap between here and that. So in this case, kind of one of my specialties is 3D printing. I use Fusion C360 as a design software. And I'm just gonna design this in Fusion 360 using some measurements. I'm going to design one, print a prototype, and see if it works. Hopefully it does, or it's at least close the first time around. And then if it doesn't, we'll make some changes and revise it and reprint it again. So follow me through this and should hopefully learn something. So first thing first, I need to know how much space I have between this plate and this plate. And the way I do that is to find some stuff laying around, hopefully. That'll make kind of measuring some of this stuff a little easier. You know, in this case, I've got some different washers I found. And start with this one. It looks like it's too big, but it's a good starting point, I think. I think it's off my GTM build, maybe. So just pop that guy in there, and actually, looks like it's a good diameter, so maybe that's a good starting point. But we're gonna try test fitting here, because if this won't cinch down, then it's too thick. So kind of like I thought, it doesn't really fit flush, so that means that that guy is too thick, but you know, the diameter seems to be perfect. So it takes some measurements. We've got about 27, 28 millimeters. It doesn't need to be perfect. I could take some calipers, but this is usually proven to be close enough. And then thickness, so I've got about 5 millimeters thick. So thinner than 5 millimeters, but not a lot because it was close to fitting. And then also to kind of test fit here, maybe runs into that little lever a little bit. But anyway, good starting point. So maybe we're gonna do like 4 millimeters thick to start, and then diameter right wise 26 to 28 millimeters, somewhere in that area. Kind of wing it a little bit and see what we got. Aside from that, we've got this little lever. So we've got to measure first off the angle between this blue line that we marked earlier and this. So this is, we're gonna call that just horizontal straight across. And then this guy, I mean, actually I don't even need to measure that. I can tell that that's a 45 degree angle just from looking at it. So what I'm gonna do in the software here in just a few minutes is I'm going to build a box out of this, and that'll be at a 45 degree angle coming out and coming across here. And then we're going to make it protrude, we'll call it down in this case, down towards this white panel to take up the space between the white panel and underneath here. And then of course fill in from there to there. The only other measurement I really need is like the diameter of how big the larger piece needs to be. So I can't, I guess I could get some calipers maybe and eyeball it a little bit there, but basically just the outer diameter of this guy is what I'm looking to fill. So looks like we've got about 40 millimeters across roughly, give or take. Yeah, about 40 millimeters. And then if we look in here, we can see, yeah, radius is about 20. So that's perfect, 40 millimeter diameter. I think that's about it. So let's jump into the Fusion 360 here in a second. Just trying a couple others here, see if any of these. Yeah, so like that actually fits nice and flush, even with the little wave in the washer. And so this is like 3 millimeters. Maybe it's 5 millimeters with that, but there are some recesses maybe sitting down inside that. So yeah, we're gonna start with 4 millimeters and, excuse me, see what we got. After our first test print, we'll know a little bit more. So let's go into Fusion 360 and start working on that. Okay, so here I am in Fusion 360, and sorry I'm narrating this kind of after the fact. I don't know if I'm good enough to talk through it at the same time I'm actually doing the work. So just to start out here, I've got the base circle, which we talked about being between 26 and 28 millimeters. I chose 27, just split the difference. Made it 4 millimeters thick, again, as kind of a base point. And then we're gonna add some additional parts here. So what I need is to make a recess where that center axle is. Wrong plane there. So we actually went on the same plane as the actual disc I already got. So now that's a good starting point, and I'm gonna use the bottom of it to draw a box, and that box is gonna become the piece that is the angled portion that sticks out, that actually makes up the gap of the throttle lock itself. So basically, remember when we measured it, we said 40 millimeters was the maximum. And then I did one other little measurement to the bottom of the lock itself. It's kind of a weird angle, but I measured that about 13 millimeters. And then I just need the radius here. looks like I typed in 10, but I'm pretty sure I meant 20. Yep, so there we go. And so that's the beginning of what's gonna be the lock portion. Now, this piece is gonna be a little bit thicker than than the rest. So let's see here, measured that and turns out we're about, gosh, 5 or 6 millimeters total. So I just type in 2.5 in addition to the 4 millimeters below. So a total of 6.5 millimeters, and that's the entire portion, including the piece that makes up the lock. So we just like look at this for a second here. All right, so we're just gonna try a couple things to see kind of what design, like what I want this to look like. It's going to be rounded like this, but so when I was doing this, I forgot kind of that I needed an angle for the first portion. So instead of going with this, I actually I'm going to back out of this here in just a second. Thought it was going to work, and then I decided, no, let's try this a different way. So it's not the shape I want because the actual angle is, remember we talked about a 45 degree angle from the bottom, but if I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna use the chamfer tool and it's not gonna work with this the way I want it to with the rounded portion there. So I just kinda undid what I was doing and here we go. So we're gonna do chamfer. And then two distances, turns out I could have done the same distance because I ended up again with the 45 degree angle. Now this was 13 millimeters, so that means each of these legs is gonna be about 13 millimeters that we're removing. So I had 15, but I'm gonna back that out and make that 13 here in just a second. I think I was thinking about the the angle that I wanted and being 45 degree angle, of course, both of the chamfer sections need to be equal. So 13 millimeters both ways. So here's 13 there and then 13 there, good to go. Perfect. So now this whole big ugly thing sticks out and we just really want it rounded. So we're gonna do the fillet tool or fillet tool, whichever you want to call it. That's got a nice round angle that kind of mimics the size of the inside circle. If we did it this way, remember this would be way too thick for the portion of it. So I'm just drawing a couple circles here. I actually didn't draw that on the correct plane. I need to draw it on the same plane as the top of the throttle lock itself for the base circle. And then I'm just gonna remove everything above that. It makes it nice concentric. So on a 20 millimeter circle there, cause it's about the size of the inner portion of the throttle lock. So we're getting there. And then we're just going to drag this down, use the join tool, and we're mostly there. The only thing left is in the center of this thing, those axles or the pivots that everything circles on, they do stick out a little bit. So to keep it from interfering, we're just gonna put a nice little 1 millimeter, so -1 circle here. And then that's it. So at this point, we're going to 3D print it. I've got it set to go to a Prusa slicer as my default. Of course, I use the Prusa printers, MK3Ss, and it always seems to import it on a right angle to where I want it, so we're just gonna flip it 90 degrees. That's what it looks like. That's exactly what we wanted. We're gonna do high amount of infill. We're printing with polycarbonate, 0.1 millimeter detail. We hit the slice now. It says it's 43 minutes worth of printing. Export it, we'll save it, name it something pretty obvious here. Throttle lock test one, first try. and then we're going to go throw this in the 3D printer. Here's one of my 3D printers printing a VVTI ETCSI delete plate, basically. Removes the throttle control motor from the 2JZ VVTI motors. Here's the printer we're gonna use today. No card in there right now, so we're just gonna pop our deal in. Just got throttle lock test print. Real quick though, I just wanna show you something. How crazy these Prusa printers are. This guy has gone through, has printed 826 days worth of filament. So 23,510 meters worth of filament. It's crazy. It's just a workhorse. So pretty neat stuff there. So we'll go up here. We're gonna print from SD. We're gonna do our throttle lock test. While that's starting to heat up, we'll grab a clean PEI sheet, like so. I always use glue stick for these. Just a little space right here in the middle. It makes it adhere well, but also when the print's done, it makes it easy to remove and also easy to clean up. No crazy chemicals or anything like that. So our bed's heating, and here in, let's see, 43 minutes. Let's speed that up a little bit. This is a test print, so we'll speed that up 130%. Just a little over half an hour after it's heated up, obviously, we will have this ready to go. And we'll see what happens and do some test fitting and go from there. All right, throttle lock is done. First instinct is that it's probably a little too thick. It's an easy thing to fix, but let's pop it off here and see what we got. Okay, so we've got the first kind of prototype throttle lock here. Saw the quick edits I made on this thing to try to make sure it's gonna fit right. So we're just gonna pop it in here and see what we've got. So one, I think it might be just a little bit too thick just looking at it versus some of the measurements I took earlier, but we're gonna try it anyways and see what we need to change. So we drop it in and we can see it actually fits nice and flat. Angles look about correct there. Actually pretty happy with that so far. We're gonna pop this guy on top. And it actually, so we've got a problem here. Hold it like so. If you can see this, there is a larger gap on the bottom here versus the top. The that tells me that it's not an overall thickness issue because I would expect it to be the same gap top and bottom. So we're gonna pull this off here and try fitting it on to the app sensor itself. In this case, this little recess in the center is for this little piece that sticks out on the app sensor. So we're just gonna pop it on there like so. You can see kind of the line I made earlier of where the throttle lock should sit. So just like that. But as I'm holding it on here, I can tell that it's not level. It's not flat. And if I look closer, this little lever, the little metal lever on the app sensor, is actually interfering with this piece of the throttle lock. So what I need to do is I need to redesign this piece to have a recess there for the lever, and then that really should be it. I'm probably gonna take a half millimeter off of the entire thickness of this just to make sure we're on the safe side of things, but I think just a couple quick modifications and we'll be all right with this. All right, so back in Fusion 360 here, just got a couple really small edits to make. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this plane over here and I'm going to just simply draw a box, and then I'm going to extrude that box like so. Remember, I'm just trying to make enough space for the little lever on the app sensor to avoid hitting this coming into contact. I don't want to delete too much because I want it to maintain some strength, but I'm just gonna eyeball it, and this looks to be about it. Nothing, no crazy measurements needed. Again, we're pretty close, I think, on this anyways. And then on the bottom side, I'm just gonna delete about a half millimeter of this just to prevent any future problems. And then we're going to export it back to Fusion 360, go print it. And when I come back, we'll be putting in version 2 of this thing. See you in a second. Okay, so back to revision 2 of the, I guess revision 1 of the first. So part number 2 that I've printed here, got our new throttle lock. It's half millimeter thinner. And I've also engineered in a small little recess here that this little lever should fit. So before it fit fine here, it was just a matter of fitment with this guy. So we're just gonna put that on there just like so. And if you look, the lever has plenty of clearance and it fits nice and flush. So we're gonna throw it into our throttle body first, just like that. This guy goes just like so. And now we've got nice flush fitment. So exactly what I'm looking for. I'm gonna try and hold this as we turn. Oh, yep, that's exactly what we're looking for. So throw a bolt or two in here, just for test fitment's sake. And I've got a whole video, a link below, that shows how to install this guy 100%, remove and install. And so we've got that guy in there, and let's see what happens. A little bit of play, that's actually normal. We want it to have just a touch. And then, oh, 100% throttle. Throttle blade is straight up and down. So that is exactly what we're looking for. So there you go, version 2 of this guy, and all is well. Thanks for watching, how to make a car part start to finish.